of software products to be delivered to software teams that came inside our systems. And since 1 year, I'm also the head and open office or project manager.
My name is Jules Andrik. I'm the program manager of StarOffice Open Office or within the Sun development, the StarOffice development inside Sun. Additionally, I'm working as a co-lead of the QA project on OOoCon.
So today we are going about short translation dream. main steps of the translation process. So once we want or a volunteer wants to translate, what are the components that need to be translated? So basically we have two components, the PIDI and the HAL, and it is all very important to know that for the PIDI and the HAL, we have two different targets of the audience. So the information that I need as a translator to translate the PIDI may be different from what I need when translating the HAL. The content to translate can be found nowadays in two different locations. One is in OOoCon, which are provided by Power. This is the link. And then on some virtual lab, on the new content server that we set up, where we are adding more amenities. And of course, in case of some community local collaboration, and in case these teams are still not on portal, then we can provide USD files via issue, as we did in the last 2 days, at least in the past 2 days. The font format to deliver back to Sun is the SDF file format. Just a recommendation to really include in this SDF file to put back or you deliver back to Sun to only translate strings, because everything goes automatically. So if you file issue and say this is the SDI file with translations, we are going to import it into the database. So if there are English strings in there, then we have no chance to check it. So you really need to delete the strings that you haven't been translated.
Translated the template test too.
Sorry,
template test.
Templates
are the translated tool to all the languages.
Oh, the template, you mean as components?
Yeah,
yes.
As we translate the GCI files. Yeah, to translate.
Yeah, but the template, you are talking about examples and templates.
Yeah, when the translation process, there are help files, interface files, yeah, and there are two templates. I was reading this how to some other system.
Yeah.
And I was thinking if using it the same way, we can submit the template and the data files to some other system.
Yeah, but usually you could deliver that final issue. Okay, and another thing is, don't forget, to run the GSI check and read the latest version of the GSI check. So when you deliver back to some via issues, then the component to select an issue is the end-to-end, the subcomponent is code, the issue time enhancement, and the summary line is ready to be put the language ID. And then if you are delivering cookie or have a translation and the name of the number of the release version.
Okay. Regarding release QA, there are several steps. The one regards the testing of the goals. We have the TCM, where we have test specifications, and for each release, at least the person who does the test for the localized version should perform sanity checks with the build, and if we are in release candidate status localized builds, language packs can be found on the extended mirror service, and this is always announced within the QA mailing list at dev.qa.openoc.org. Before release candidates are built, it would be very helpful for the native language teams to have a look at the English builds of the developer snapshots, which are provided quite often, to have a look at the functionality, to be able to work with the application, and but the scope of native language teams is not to do tests, functional testing on the application, but checking the translations and to check builds containing the own translation of the application, to check the resources which have been built, because if you are using a broken resource file, then and open a dialog that has a broken resource, then the application would crash. So it's very important for the teams, for the localization teams, to have at least a look at the most important dialogues. In this case, using the test tool really helps. And it's, from my perspective, from my opinion, it's more important to check the translations using the test tool than doing QA and doing tests on the builds manually. Is not so important, because the application must function at when the release process begins, and everything that is not found at that time, it's nearly too late and must be found, but it's really late within the process of the release process. Information about the testable environment is printed within the presentation here. You can get the testable environment from Anon CDS. And for each release, we have a separate test tool environment. In case of the OpenOps.org 2.3, that would be the tag 00230. Okay, how to get an alternate build? Native language teams, which provide translations, should have at least 80% UI translation to get at least the language pack from built by Sun. And if there is additionally 80% help content translated, then the release is tracked at least once a time within the last releases, then the full installation set is going to be created. And that's for a lot of native language teams, it would be very, very good to have a primarily have about more than 18 language packs and about 16 full posts. Which languages are built is published within the wiki page of the releases. For the 2.3 release, it would be all releases 2.3 on wiki.services. So, what to do to get the build distributed? At least the build should be included into the database on qatrack.services.openops.org to show that the build has been QA approved. And additionally, the native language team should file an issue to the issues at QA mailing list. You can pick up issue 79189 as an example how this should look like. And if you want to get the builds distributed, we have a quite big mirror network. And we have an application by the open source lab of the University of Oregon. It's called Bouncer. It's a load balancer, which balances downloads by round robin. And so you get your build distributed to several mirrors worldwide. So the users, if they want to download the build, it's not depending on just one FTP server. And so we do not have those problems with bandwidth, like if we have just one FTP server. Okay, this is an example of builds that have been distributed for the 2.2.1 version. All these builds are within the mirror network. As you see, that could be more. Okay. Then just wanted to start the round of questions and answers. Thank you.
Development 2.3, so we try, Japanese community try to find out mistranslation or sometimes translation that could be improved or revised. But some of the period of the test was so tight, was and I missed some mistranslation. I reported through the issue there, issue tracker, but by the proposal of new revised translation, missed 2.3. So for the next release, 2.3.1 or 3.0, It would be great. We have regularly longer what say period to review or check translation.
It's a well-known issue. You know that is said that with all these updates, which were at the beginning on a quarterly basis every 3 months, and now on 6 months, we still have very short time, you know, really to have them fixed. So the situation at the moment is not really very satisfying. Neither for me, you know, I know. So we hope, you know, for the 3.0 to have, you know, better time frames. Yeah.
But we already shifted the milestones for 2.0. So as I remember, we just on the each of these 2 weeks.
Yeah, I think that Sora, as far as I listen, Sora wanted to know in the 3.0. But yeah, we shifted to 6 months period.
Another thing that might help here, and what I experienced with the release or testing localization in computer 3, was that some missing localizations or some missing strings have been reported for several languages at different times. That means a certain team reported a missing string hard. 2 weeks later, by the news team, found the same missing string. So I think we maybe can find some tools to notify the localization teams, or at least push if we see this is a central resource missing, that we notify the mailing list about that. So what I have done for myself is to go through the issues that have been filed from the native projects within the time frame. What else is going to do?
It would be really great that once you test or you find something that you like, write a very short testing report, you know, and then you, so that the other teams can see that, you know. If you send it, I think, you know, that if you have a testing report and then you post it to the list, then the other teams see the testing report. They can easily see if this is something that it's only applies to your language or functions already, or they already have. In all of the TCM, you can also find testing reports there. And you need all, you know, to send out the link, and everybody can go and home.
Well, this is from TCM, because not all of those issues have been clarified testing. You wouldn't have those cases in TCM, but at least you would have the issue.
Yeah. We would need to notify all the lists as
well. If we talk about release QA, I think the native language team should be a bit more
feel more comfortable and do not try to do everything in every test. It's, for example, something which I found that, for example, the Japanese team, which does a lot of automation tests. I think it's not really necessary for a release test. And the native language team should relax a bit at the release.
Or do this work in the early stage?
But also communicate among the other teams, you know.
Next point, to do this work in an earlier stage, you need localized builds in an earlier stage.
Yes. But of course, we can only, you know, do these things once we have integrated the translations, you know, instead of build, because otherwise it doesn't make any sense, you know, that's all we have, not the latest translations. So that's a difficult situation. Okay, for the next two documentations, four releases, so the release is CVS and build, which is scheduled, you know, I think second week in November. So that's at least for the focus and would give the possibility to test on this CVS delta and build the new translation, the new documents, you know, at another stage. So there is of course then a second update, mid of November, but at least we know for the first hand off to do some testing. And the target to have is the issue fixed would be the 13th of December. So
Robert from Slovenian language project. We use Pavel's build system, greatest latest. And I had an issue lately with Sun builds. For our language, Sun is doing builds also. Is it possible that Sun would download SDS file just before the final release is out? Because it's possible. You have a deadline when you must create an issue and report where the SDF file is. But if you later find some problems in this SDF file, you can ask if Sun could download SDF file again and build a localized version with the newest SDF file. Would this be possible or not? Because if I ask Pavel, I just mail him, please Pavel, when you will make him M3, M4 builds, please download SDF file again and deal with this new one.
It's a problem in the release engineering process at startup. We cannot really build, you know, so many builds, so many end-to-end builds, because it's really a resource and time issue. That's the problem that we have. So we are, yeah, sorry, it's not possible.
what example do you mean? Do you mean the features that the example that document for it to process these features or what do you mean?
Yes, example documents.
Then we want to bring them also in the test case area automatically. That's in progress and we will think in 1 month we will have it.
But test case we are going to
No, I mean do not mean TCM. TCM is currently for me the tooling where the localization test cases are in. And the other part I talk about is the general testing area, the QA project, where you find for the application driver also the test cases. The test case application is probably used.
And these functional are, tests.
Yeah, at least these are in general not really related to the version, the language where it's integrated. Only when you really have issues with this language, then we have to bring it into TCM. But I think, in my opinion, it's not good to have two or more tools for handling the test case applications. So, in my opinion, we should talk about, not here, but in the future, about one tooling to handle all the test cases in one tool and to monitor the results of the tool and of the test cases and so on. But I work with one guy who makes the database internally for the test tool, and we want to bring this database also on in the OpenOffice community. And all test results can be sent to the database, and you get an overview of all the test runs which were done. So you can compare your test results with other languages or with the test results of the OOoCon team. We will bring them also to the database, and the same we want to do, the same tooling and the same result page we want to do for normal manual tests. Mm-hmm. But that's, then we are not so far, it's already in our mind, but we have not really tuned it now. But we have to start for the test tool environment and the other thing kind of an expansion on this. So then we can have one tooling, but that's in my opinion the best thing, but I do not know if other ones, TCM and others. For the new features and the test case presentation there, it's not needed that every community, every language community make the tests. That's why we have want to have QA teams for the writer, where different language teams are in.
Yeah.
Yeah. I tend to do it because new features introduces new strings.
Yes,
and I do. UI is new.
That's why you want a new test presentation to copy. And when we say tests, not to check the program first, but to see the how it has worked.
I know, yes. But that is not what you can talk about test and check the translation. That's for me different parts.
Yeah, I know.
You need a way how to get the dialogues, the scripts and so on, which came up. That's for you. And you need, don't do not need the full functionality test case. That's true.
Yeah. But if it's all the F,
Yeah, I know.
So, what work at the moment, and what
modification and then came back and said, we're dropping an error back in the system. I think it was a good issue.
Recently, I thought Rafael made a rich case to ask community grant rate and put some ODF files in the issue. And I download such ODF file and expand it on header content and UI string. UI strings are grouped by something like dialog. So in this case, I try to make help review systems. This is a very big spreadsheet, unlisted, same as for the each line has each entry. And quickly, English version of help and your translation version of online help. You can see the same translation, original one and translated one at the same time. It's very good to review because we can see content. And another one, I didn't make it. I haven't made it in this 2.3, but for 3.0, I want to make a plan to create a big page like that. And put ODF file or a small portion of ODF file, groupify it to one dialog or something like that. Okay. To ask reviewer to see how to get the dialog. So ask community to create a big page. For example, chat 2.3 has a new feature of chat. So chat has got have some new dialogs. So you can first start impress and insert chat or something. So you can you will get this dialog. English, the snapshot of English version is to be helpful. And our localized version, I can see and check translation already. So it's going to be very big, long wiki pages. But what I want to say, once translation has made, it could be very hard to revise. It's costly. Each translation, each issue, and submit each issue, submit 10 issues, 100 issues, it's going to be costly. So try to revise and as early as possible. So what I wanted to say is for 2.3, we can have some good new plan for reviewing system. Review translation.
How about to do screenshots of all dialogues automated by the test tool?
By hand?
And taking.
No, with the test.
With the test tool.
Oh, yeah,
yes,
we do.
And then you pick up the bitmaps and you have something to compare to look at the dialogues which text can be put into the dialogue.
So to do
it's already working.
By yourself or by one person.
Yeah.
Ask community to distribute one person, not one person, 10 person or 20, 30 person. Who can say?
This is something that nobody in the community has already built because the description on how to do it and the screenshots, I think it's also included in one of the testing messages here. This is something that the community
German community did it once. I do understand the problem. Any more questions?
All the testing again. At the moment, Sun's doing the functionality tests or complete test suite on all Sun's support languages. That's a very good show. It's great. What is with non-Sun support languages? Would you advise them to do those tests as well? Or do you consider this enough to test the functionality in a given set of languages?
That's a difficult answer.
The test will run on our languages, but error messages when it's not supported, but the screens are more detailed and so on. When teams cannot support the automatic testing in Sun with this with fixes or the screens or such kind of things, then we
normally the update test is enough. And I think in the update test, in general, shouldn't be many technical issues in. But I don't know exactly. Perhaps we can eliminate all the I do not know what we do. All we have to make is a subset of tests where we know that there are translation issues in scripts. Perhaps we can do it. I do not know.
It would be quite difficult because some test scripts just check on install of the test script with some string conditions or I think it's a task of about 3 days to get all this issues resolved for language.
As I know, we try to make it easier to bring translation into the script. It's very difficult with some parts because every developer for the testing have another mechanism to bring the translation into it, but they're aligning all the tooling so that most of them bring on script, you have to start and that pick up all the translation and you can send these files which were generated to the owner of the test and then we bring it into the CDS and then run. Hopefully with less errors.
So, to the question again, so if one localization team does not have the resources to run any of the functionality tests, it would be safe to release.
Yeah. It's also up to the alternate teams to release the version. We cannot currently, as I think, we cannot make a control mechanism overall to say you can release, you cannot release, so the open-end teams have to decide how much testing is needed.
There are some language-specific parts of the application which should be looked at, for example, linguistics. If the spell checker works, if there is a resolver that works correctly,
that's just the semi test. Yes,
yeah.
But if it doesn't pass, what is the
problem? How?
If it doesn't pass, what happens then?
Something breaks within the release candidate, then it's definitely a showstopper.
It's a showstopper, and it means that it really needs to be fixed, and then once it is fixed,